There are three primary types of giving in Islam. Two of these giving methods are mandatory, while one is highly recommended, but not obligatory. The first obligatory act of giving is called Zakat al-Mal, which is the zakah given from one's saved wealth and liquid assets. The second obligatory zakah is called Zakat al-Fitr, which is a special type of zakah due at the end of the month of Ramadan to be paid by the head of the household. The third type of giving in Islam is called Sadaqah, which is voluntary and can be given at any time on any amount. Sadaqah comes from an Arabic word meaning sincerity, as giving sadaqah or charity is a sign of sincere faith in God on the part of the person who bestows it. Sadaqah is described in the Holy Quran as a beautiful loan, which includes any act of charitable giving made as a gesture of love and generosity. Whether the act stands in the form of giving money or time, helping others, praying for someone, spreading knowledge, giving advice, forgiving someone, visiting the sick, or even smiling at someone. Zakat plays a major role and holds a high commendable standard in Islam, to the extent that about 36 verses in the Holy Quran links the mandatory prayers to charity. God describes the true believers as the ones that both pray their necessary prayers and give zakat. This proves the concept that zakat is the believer's most important obligation after the mandatory prayer. Indeed, those who believe and do righteous deeds and establish prayer and give zakat will have their reward with their Lord, and there will be no fear concerning them, nor will they grieve. All things belong to God, and God has given wealth to certain individuals so they can distribute resources to those that are not as fortunate. People are given wealth as a trust from God to distribute and benefit the ones in need. The true owner of all things is not man, but God, and we human beings are merely his trustees. God, who provided wealth to the intended recipient, reserved a portion of the given resources for the poor, so the unprivileged have a right claim a proportion of one's wealth. The concept of zakat, in essence, reminds Muslims that everything they possess belongs to the Almighty. Additionally, people are given their wealth as a test from God. Wealth should be acquired, distributed, and spent in a way which is pleasing to God. And it is He Our Prophet narrated, whoever guides another to a good deed will get a reward similar to the one who performs it. So please like, subscribe, and share this video. Assalamu alaikum.